Glad to be here today.
Hallelujah.
Amen. As we continue to pray for Mr. Morris, amen, head coach of Mercyville this morning for the Youth Day, and we want to honor our youth pastor.
Yes.
Amen. And the youth department for doing a great job.
Amen.
Also, Mr. Beard, and also my son, Christopher. Amen. We'll thank God for them being over our youth department.
Amen.
And doing a great job.
Yes.
So I say amen.
Amen.
So we will keep you in prayer. And also, I thank God for our new lineup of musicians.
Amen.
Amen. So glad to see these young men in action. Amen. I thank God for y'all been on the drums. Thank you, sir. Amen. Been on the drums and helping out. And my own son, Kristen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. And he played. Amen. And enjoyed himself. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you all, amen, for continuing to pray for our praise team as they begin to work together.
Amen.
And I'm pretty sure, amen, Pastor Jones is going to be working with them, amen, and constantly, amen, training and teaching and guiding them. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Because worship, I listened to Apostle Eckhart last night. I don't know if anybody else listened to him last night. He did a very scope, we call it prayer scope, a scope on worship.
Yes.
On worship leaders.
Amen.
Amen. You are gatherers. You gather the people into the frame of mind.
Yes.
And so worship service is very important.
Yes.
It cannot be a point where I'm going to entertain or I'm going to be up front.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is the teaching from Apostle Eckhart. So
yes.
To our worship leaders, amen, y'all practicing. So I'm so glad y'all practicing.
Yes.
So glad y'all coming together. So I say amen.
Amen.
Because they are not up there to entertain you.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
They are to usher you into a time of worship.
Yes.
And coming together to give God the praise for what he has done for you.
Yes.
And if you are sitting here today, regardless if you're broke, rich, sick, or healthy,
yes,
this still the glory of God.
Amen.
And God's grace is still good.
Yes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But there are some who wish they could be in your seat.
Amen.
And there are some people who wish they could be in your body.
That's right.
Amen. Amen, Lord.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You complaining about it, you don't have this, you feel that, you feel this. Oh, this hurt, that hurt, that hurt. But some folk would love to be able to walk into the house of God.
Yeah.
Just one more time.
Amen.
And sit down. And give God the praise.
Yeah.
And God have no sin. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But we come in, oh, child, I'm tired of love. Lonely days, I sure don't, you know, but there are people, amen, who would love to walk in this house and say, Lord, I'm thankful for touching my body. I'm thankful in my right mind.
Yes.
Oh, glory to God.
Jesus.
Amen. I visited my mom in the nursing, she's in the nursing home department of the facility she's in now, and I see people there in such bad shape.
Amen.
And she can't use all her extremities like she used to, but at least she's in her right mind.
Amen.
Amen.
Some, amen, have lost them. They're not even in their right mind.
Amen.
Oh, no, I'm saying amen.
Amen.
No visitors. No visitation. Amen.
Amen.
So we just thank God, amen, for being here today. Thank God for your strength. Thank God for your help. And thank God for you being here, amen. And thank God for you in the right frame of mind, amen, to give God some praise. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And today, amen, I'm going to close up this series, amen, on living in the goodness of God by sharing with you, amen, a series that are one part of the message of the series that we missed. But I got a chance to come back to it. And that is a relaxing in God's goodness. How to relax in God's goodness. Some folks, and can I just say it like they would say, some of you need to chill.
Amen.
You all hyper, you all stressed out, and pray to God, and I know you are because you're talking crazy. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Don't I always tell you amen, your mouth will always tell on you?
Yes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You might look good, feel good, got all the stuff together, and your parents look all well until you open your mouth.
Amen.
You were doing good until you start talking.
Yes.
Amen. You got in the car, everything was cool, everything was flowing until you opened your mouth. How many of y'all pick somebody up and you get in that, they get in your car and they change the whole atmosphere? You were feeling good, you was having a good day, and they got in and thought talking, you like, oh God. But you can't do nothing, you can't say but amen. Just say amen.
Amen.
You might be sitting next to the person that you just picked up last week. they literally wore you out. You were glad to get where you was going. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
And you were glad to drop them off. All y'all can say is amen. Yeah. Amen. Because some people don't know how to relax in God's goodness.
Yeah. Amen.
And I don't care what you say or what you have right now, God's been good to you.
Yeah. Good. Yes.
It might not be perfect, but God is still good to you.
All the time.
And all the time and all the time.
God is good.
God is good.
Yeah. God is great.
But can we relax in God's goodness?
Yes.
So we're going to need some issues as to why you can't relax or why you have not relaxed in God's goodness. And then we're going to give you some practical points how to walk in and relax and enjoy the goodness of God.
Amen.
Because the enemy, remember John 10:10? Jesus' purpose, there were two purpose statements made. One was Satan and one was the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Satan's job come to do what? Come on.
Steal, kill,
and what did Jesus say I come to do?
Feed.
How?
Feed.
Yes. Two purpose statements were stated in John 10:10. Somebody say amen. And you didn't understand that, right? The devil, amen, is coming to kill, steal, and destroy. Amen.
Amen.
And if he can't steal your joy, if he can't destroy, praise God, he'll make it, praise God, that it's not effect.
Amen.
You can't even smile. Somebody say amen.
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 Something that can be funny, like, it ain't even that funny. It's funny now. Come on. Sometimes you need to laugh.
Yeah.
Laughter is good medicine. Yeah. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Walking out your face all torn up, coming to church, I look all holy and serious and everything right. Chill
out. Amen.
You're not that deep. None of us is that deep.
Amen.
Right? And none of your problems is so hard that God cannot solve it.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you don't believe, listen to the man who had the pool. And every time Jesus said, do you want to be healed? No, every time with somebody, I want to get in the water. Somebody beat me in. I ain't got nobody to carry me. So Jesus said, solve the problem. He said, pick up your bed and come on, man, in front.
Amen.
So a lot of times we want God to bless us, but we won't take care of what's holding us up.
Yes.
Amen.
It's time you to pick yourself up now.
Yes.
Amen. And start trusting God.
Amen.
And you can do that when you relax in God's goodness.
Yes.
Somebody say, give God a hand, praise. And all right, let's give him a hand, bless him, amen. That we might, amen. I want you to really now, next week, to all our those who take care of things right, we want to have the table already set up, everything set up. When we come in here right, they can sit at the table right. We have our Field Study Fellowship. We're going to have a Field Study Fellowship next Sunday. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I want to broadcast this now, praise God, and get it out to you now. Amen. We want to pack this house. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The table already set out. They can come in and sit right at the table. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And after service, I'm going to preach a short message to you. Amen. Praise God. And,
amen.
And then we're going to have served dinner. We're going to serve you dinner.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the plan for next week, right?
Amen.
Amen. Now, don't flake it on me. Y'all made those plans.
Amen.
Right? So amen. So let's make it happen. All right? Let's make it happen. Amen. I'm not getting all these meetings in there. If we miss a business meeting or something like
that.
Amen. Amen. So we're going to amen. All right. So y'all get it together. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Amen. All right. So praise God. We're going to do that. Amen. And I want you to invite your friends and family to come out. Amen. And I'm starting the 29th. Praise God. I'm reminding you on the 29th. Let's have our fellowship, amen, our free giveaway. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to put my closet down, praise God. I'm getting our clothes. If it's too big, amen. I thank God I'm losing weight.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I'm starting to feel better. I'm down to 211 now.
Amen.
I'm 213 last week. I'm down to 211. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. My goal is to be back to 200 when I retire in 2000 for the military. Somebody say amen. I'm getting back to 200. Really back to 185. Amen. I feel better.
Amen.
Amen. I even think I look good.
Amen.